Graphite, speaking with Phil Hoskins this morning from Evolution Energy Minerals. Phil, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you?
Yeah, good, Phil. Significant update this morning here. Tell us a bit about this new discovery to the east of the Chilalo project area.
Yeah, it was the first drilling we've done in probably 4 years on the project, and we always knew from the electromagnetic conductors in the area that we had a lot of graphite mineralization out there, but decided we wanted to be able to demonstrate the scale potential of the project, the ability to double, triple production, grow mine life, reduce mining costs by mining more at surface. And this program was designed to do that. And so the first batch of results has confirmed a new discovery out to the east. It's about 1.5 kilometers that we've intercepted it over. But appears from the electromagnetics to go for almost 4 kilometers, and that's one of I guess many trends in the region, with other results still to come. But yeah, fantastic to see some good high grades, some good thicknesses. All the graphite is from surface, so we know it's going to be low strip ratio, and really confirmed what we're seeking, which was is there going to be more than the existing 17-year mine life at Chilalo? And the answer is absolutely.
Well, that's what I was going to ask. So you're talking here resource expansion potential. Just remind us about some of the production profile and some of the numbers around the existing project.
Yeah, so 500,000 tonne per annum of feed to produce around 55,000 to 60,000 tonnes per annum of concentrate over 17 years, just based on reserves. And so that's a 2 kilometer strike length, really, that's all coming from. So the fact that we've sort of hit over 1.5 kilometers here, we think it's this one's 4 kilometers long. There's a conductor to the north that's about 5 kilometers long. Overall, there's about 30 kilometers of conductors through this region. So yeah, how long's a piece of string as to how big it can get. But I guess the other encouraging thing is that we've still got a little bit more to do in terms of understanding the model and how do these conductors sort of guide us towards the thickest parts of the deposits or the highest grade. And it's a bit of a dark art, but we're feeding that through. And if we do some downhole electromagnetics as well, we can see if we may have even missed a few graphite horizons with this drilling. So I think over the longer term, we need to work those things through and I guess prioritize expenditure against trying to move the project towards production as quickly as possible. But yeah, I'm sure it'll be one of those things that we just keep peppering away at over the coming year, 2 years. And but the end game will be, I think, one of the largest graphite deposits in Tanzania.
And I suppose just a bit nearer term, Phil, what are you working on currently? What are the upcoming milestones?
Yeah, so the next cab off the rank, I'm heading to Tanzania again this weekend. We're running a project financing process, and so some of the banks, independent technical engineer, independent environment and social consultant, coming to site. So that's one of the sort of critical milestones in that process. So yeah, continuing on with project financing. I think we've spoken before about the excellent test work of our graphite into coated spherical graphite. We've got some commitments around our intention to have the US downstream strategy, and some key appointments around that to really drive that in the US, which is a really topical thing at the moment, being critical mineral supply in this sort of current geopolitical environment. The US government very keen to secure critical minerals ex-China, and a lot of funding around to do that. So yeah, advancements on the funding and the downstream, as well as the rest of the drill results still to come out. Plenty of things still happening at Evolution.
Good to speak, Phil. Thanks very much.
You too. Thank you, Andrew.